subtractor for sine. So we consider the set S, which corresponds to the graph of the sine function. So it is a set of all xy which satisfy this equation. What we'll do in this exercise is to build a contractor for this function, for this set, and then we'll use it to solve some trigonometric equations such as this one. So this is the sine function. Here I have x and y, and this set in blue corresponds to the set S. So this is a set S which is equal to the all x and y such that y equals sine of x. So I can see this set as a function but also as a set, and this set is called the graph of the function. What we'll do first is that we will consider a subset of this set, and this set I will draw it red, for instance, or magenta here, and this set is called S0. And I have to build a contractor for this one, and we know that the sine function on this domain is monotonic. So we define S0 is equal to the intersection of S and a box which is minus p divided by 2 Cartesian product with minus 1 and 1. So I represent this box here like this. So this point corresponds to x equal p divided by 2 minus p divided by 2, 1 and minus 1. So for, and this is the set I am interested with. So for this, consider a box. So how I will perform this contraction? I will consider a box. So I will represent, for instance, this box. And since I consider only this magenta part, the best contraction I can see is the smallest box which encloses all these points. Okay, so this smallest box corresponds to this. And it corresponds to a contractor associated to S0, and this contractor I will call it C0. So how can I do program this, taking into account that the sine function on this domain is monotonic? So it is quite simple. This box is a Cartesian product of two intervals. This interval, this one, and this interval, I represent like this. So the Cartesian product of this interval and this interval correspond to this box. So how can I do this? I will first have x as an input, and x is this one. So first, I know that this intersection is inside this box, so I will first perform the intersection between x and the domain minus p divided by 2. So as a consequence, I eliminate all this part which is not inside the box. Then I am here. Since it is monotonic, I know that y, for y I don't know yet where it is, but I will perform the following contraction. I will do the intersection with y and sine of x minus sine of x plus. So it means that here it is x minus, the lower bound of x, and x plus is this one, the upper bound of x after the previous contraction. Then I will compute the image of this point and I will get this for y in this example, and for this one I will obtain this point. So as a consequence, this interval corresponds to that. But I know that y should be here, so I will do the intersection between the green and the violet, and this corresponds to this contraction. I have contracted y without removing any consistent value. Then the next step I will is for x, and x, the contraction will be like this, intersected by between arc sine of y minus, arc sine of y plus, and this is due also to the fact that it is monotonic inside here. So I take this point and this point, I will come back with this sine function, and I will obtain, after intersection, the new x corresponding to this. So in fact, I will get this box. It is easy to understand that this contractor is optimal. I propose to program in Python this one in order to and to validate on a CVA algorithm. So this is the Python program I propose. And this corresponds to a contractor. I will call it, in the exercise, it is denoted by C0. And here I will call it C sine 0. Here. So here x and y are are intervals. I will perform here this contraction. Here this one, and here this one. So note that I use mat.py, which is a Python module. Okay, so this is a contraction. How can I validate it? I will put this contractor inside the CVA algorithm as represented here. So it is a pathing algorithm which will bisect box until they get smaller than a given value. And at each step, I will contract it. And I will draw the corresponding box. And when I take a box like this, I will paint it blue here. Then after, I will contract. And after contraction, I will draw yellow. After, I will bisect them. So they will be painted again blue, and everything will overlap, and at the end what will be yellow is only the small boxes. So we'll see this immediately. Here I initialize my box until minus 10 to 10, this is for x, and this is for y. I called CVA here. I take Python, here I run my program, and I can see here the contraction with the boxes generated by the CVA. If I zoom, I see the yellow boxes. Okay, I can see that all these boxes, all of them touch the set S0 represented here. As a consequence, I can conclude that graphically the contractor is minimal from the contractor C0 associated to S0. I will have to build another contractor C1 for a set S1 which is the intersection of the graph of the sine function with another box, this box. And to build this contractor, I will have to use the contractor C0 and to take into account the fact that I have a symmetry with respect to the line x equal p divided by 2. So I will explain this now. Recall that I have the graph of sine function given here. Here I have p divided by 2. And here is a line, vertical line, corresponding to x equal p divided by 2. The set S0 is this one. It is the intersection of the graph of the function S with this box. Now I consider another box here. And this set here, corresponding to this part of the graph, is named S1. And I have to build a contractor for this. So how I will do? I will consider a box, for instance, this one, this box. And this box contains some points, such as this point, which is x and y. So for each of these points, since the graph is symmetric with respect to this line, I have another point, this one, which is symmetric of this point with respect to this line. And this point, I will call it x0, 0, because it corresponds to the set S0. And this is another point. And what I know is that the mean between x and x0 is equal to p divided by 2 due to the symmetry. Or if you prefer, I have x0 plus x is equal to pi due to the symmetry. So how can I perform the geometrically this contraction? I take this one, this box, I will do the symmetry, and the symmetry will generate another box like this. I will perform the contraction here, because I have a contractor for this, it is C0. I will come back here by another symmetry, and this, the one I will obtain, corresponds to the contraction with respect to S1. So I will do this thanks to this relation. So I have this relation, and how I can do this, I will build this one will be represented by the interval. I will call it let's say p, like this. It is equal to pi pi. Normally, due to the rounding error, I should round toward infinity the upper bound, so, and toward infinity the lower bound. So it is some kind of what we call outward rounding. So pi is here, but pi is not representable in the machine. So there is many floats near pi, but pi is not represented. So usually I represent this one by an interval, which is called pi here, like this. But for simplicity, I assume that the lower bound and the upper bound are the same, but in practice, the outward bounding should be done. X0. X0 is this number, is between minus p divided by 2, p divided by 2. So I will initialize this one, x0, the corresponding interval, to minus p divided by 2, p divided by 2. Then I will, in my contractor, I have as an input x and y, which are known, and they correspond to this box here, x and y. Okay, so now, due to this relation, I will call the contractor for the addition that has already been programmed in the previous exercise and has been called CAD. So CAD of pi x0 and x, and this contractor will contract all this interval. So this one of course will not be contracted, but x0 and x, taking this one into account. In my context, of course, only this one will be contracted. Okay, now I will use the previous contractor, so I will call it C sine 0 of x0 y, which will contract as represented here. X0 will be contracted, then after I will have to propagate backward to x, so I will put here C add again of pi x0 and x. Okay, if I do this, I will obtain this Python algorithm. Here. So I define pi here like this, x0 here, the sum here, the previous contractor here, and this one here. So this will contract the interval x and y, so I return them. And I will use it in the CV algorithm as explained here. And normally, it should compute, approximate the set S1, which is this part of the sine function. So, of course, after I will have to perform some kind of union, but also some periodicities also. I switch to Python. So, C sine 0 already programmed before. Here, C sine. Recall that the contractor I use here, C add, is in my contractor here, C add, here, and use some interval arithmetics as given here. Okay, so now I run this program and I will obtain, as expected, this part of the graph of the sine function. Question number three, we take into account the fact that S is symmetric with respect to a translation of k to pi, where k is an integer. And from this, we have to build a contractor for the graph of the sine function. So of course, we'll use the contractor C0 and C1 built in the previous questions. A set A is said to be symmetric by a translation of V if A belongs to A, implies A plus V belongs also to A, and A minus V also belongs to A. Okay. This is an example is given here. The set we have in red here, A, is symmetric by translation. So if I have a set, let's say this one for instance, A0, then the set A corresponds to the smallest set which is symmetric by a translation by V, which contains A0. Okay, so we understand that for my problem with a sine function, which is here. I have my set S0, which is represented here, like this, which stops here and here. And the set I now represent red, like this one. And here also. But I have also to include this one, corresponds to the smallest set which is symmetric by a translation by 2 pi with respect to x, which contain S0. And it is the one I want to compute, and for this I will build a contractor for this. Then after I will do the same with S1, and I will regenerate something like this, and I will take the union of these two sets, the blue and the red, to obtain a contractor for the sine, for the graph of the sine function. We consider the red set containing this and this, and we'll call it the symmetric, which is the smallest symmetric set containing S0 and with which is periodic respect to x translation of 2 pi. So if I how can I see if a point, let's say x and y, belongs to this set? So for simplicity I will call it S0 periodic, like this. How can I see if one point x and y belongs to this? Then I will write as follows: xy belongs to S0P can be decomposed as follows. There is a correspondent here where I have the Z, so that ZY belongs to S0. So I will have ZY belongs to S0. How can I see if the correspondence between Z and X? So I will define here the vector D like this, and I will write D equal X minus Z, and D should belongs to 2 pi Z, where this one is a set of integers that can be positive or negative. I can represent the correspondence between the variable by a graph. So I will have here y, which is related by a constraint I represent by S0 between and Z. So S0 can be seen as a set, but also as a constraint between two variables, y and z. This one tells me that if I know z and y, x by a plus, so I represent like this, with x, I will generate d. So there is some kind of order, because the plus goes to this direction. X equal D plus Z. Then once I have D, I know that D satisfies constraints of periodicity, which tells me that it belongs to 2πz. So the circle corresponds to the constraint. Then how can I will implement my contractors? As follows, my intermediate variable z and d, I don't know where they are, so I initialize z at minus infinity plus infinity. So now I am building the contractor. D also, I don't know where it is, so minus infinity plus infinity at the beginning. Then I will perform a contraction with respect to S0, so this contraction I will call it C, can be any other contractor as soon as I want to propagate with respect to the periodicity. So I will write ZNY. So contraction between Z and Y. And we can see that in my example, the uncertainty will propagate in this direction. Then this one will tell me that Z C add between Z D and X, okay, which tells me that Z is a sum of D and X. And now the uncertainty has propagated in this direction. Then I will write here that I should satisfy this constraint. So we'll see why, but I will call it C modulo. It is a contractor associated with the modulo, and the modulo will be will have some kind of periodicity, which will be 2 pi in my example, but in the general case it can be another number. So it is why here I will write contract respect to D, and the periodicity I will call it A, for instance. In my example it will be 2 pi. Then the uncertainty on D has been propagated from this constraint, and I will have to propagate backward. This is why I will have to recall here C add of Z, D and X, the same as this one. And then again, so the uncertainty has propagated like this. And now I will call this one again X and Y. So the input of my algorithm are input of the algorithm are X and Y, and the output will also be X and Y. So it corresponds to the contractor of periodicity. Now I need to program this one, so this one, the modulo. So the modulo is, I will do first with A equal to 1, and I will call it C integer, the contraction for an integer. So if I give an interval X, so like this, this is a real line. I have 0, 1, 2, 3, and so on. If I know that this X is like this, if I know that it contains an unknown integer, then this integer cannot be here, cannot be here. This is why I will be able to contract like this. So this contraction will give me, it will do as will be as follows: X equal sale of X minus the lower bound of X. So this one is sale of X minus, and this one is X minus. Here it is X plus, and this one will be floor of X plus. So sale of floor of the upper bound X plus. So this is the contraction for the integer constraint. And now I will be able to build for the modulo C modulo of X, and I will give a periodicity, and this periodicity can be called A, and in my example A equal to pi. So how can I do this? I want to implement the constraints X equal A, so in my example is 2 pi multiplied by k, but I know that k is an integer. So belongs to Z. So how can I do this? I will have to define the interval A, and in my example it will be A and A, because A here is a known value of periodicity, but it is not always the case, but here it is A and A. Then due to this I will write simult the contractor for x, y and k, but k has to be initialized here since I don't know it at minus infinity plus infinity. And I know that k is an integer, so I will have to call the contractor c integer of k as defined here. And then again I will have to perform a contraction, this one again, so simult of x, y, a and k. So let me explain this. If I draw the graph of constraints, I will have here the multiplication a k and here x. Okay, so this is a link between the three variables, and here I will have the fact that this one belongs to Z. So first, what I have done here, I have propagated the uncertainty from A and K like this, but after, then this one has contracted K, but this uncertainty, this contraction in K, has to be propagated backward, and this is what is done by this statement. This is a Python program which will perform the periodicity of the C sign set. I have my contractor for the fact that x should be an integer, given here, and it corresponds to this function. Then for the modulo, it is given by this, and in Python corresponds to this. Now the periodicity. So in Python I am allowed to put inside the argument of the function a contractor C, which can be any contractor. For my example it will correspond to the C sign contractor given here, and from this contractor I will build a new contractor which will be the periodic of the C sign contractor. So it is an operation on contractor. From a contractor, C periodic will generate another contractor which will be called by the CVR function. Here I give the periodicity I want, it is 2 pi, and this is implemented here. I take my Python program given here, C sine 0, I run it, and this is the periodicity contractor associated to C sine 0. So I can put also, for instance, instead of putting 2 pi, I can put something different, for instance 0.2 pi, and I will get something different, which is given here, of course. Okay. Now, instead of putting this one, I can put this one, C sine 1, and we understand that I obtain this. To build a contractor for the sine function, I will make the union with between the contractor for the periodic of S1 and that for the periodic for S0. So let me illustrate this. I consider a box like this. The contractor for the blue will give me this box, The contractor for the red will give me this box. And if I make the union of the two of them, it will return me this box. So it is a union of the two contractors. And I generate two boxes and I make the union. This corresponds to the following Python program, csign. Here I will generate the contractor for the periodic of csign 0, the red, the periodic for csign 1, the blue. The contraction will give me x0, y0, x1, y1, and I will make the union of these two intervals to generate the contraction x and y from two intervals x and y. And this will be used in the CV algorithm. This is the program. I run it. And I can see that I have the contractor for the sine function. I can see also that none of the box is isolated. So it means that each of the box touch the graph of the function. So it means that the contractor is minimal. Question number four, I have to use this contractor to solve a trigonometric equation, which is given by the cosine minus the sine of x squared equal to 0, and x should belong to minus 10, 10. I have to solve the equation for cos x minus sine x squared equal 0. So I decompose as follows. Y equal cos x, and y is also equal to sine square. So I will be able to see on the xy plane what happened and to isolate the solution from this. Consider first this constraint. This one I can represent like this. The graph of constraints, I have x, then I consider square, and it generates me another variable. I will call it x2, for instance, because it's the square of x. And then I take the sine. It is a constraint also, which will link x2 to another variable, which is y. From this, I can directly use a forward-backward contractor. And this, I will call it, for instance, contractor C, C like contractor sine square, okay, because it is a sine of a square of x and y. So the intermediate variable x2 are initialized to minus infinity plus infinity. And I will perform the propagation in this direction, the forward, and then the backward. So the forward is c square of x2x. So it will contract x2. After I will have c sine of so x2 and y, and this will contract both x2 and y. So I have started at this step the backward, and then after I will have to do c square of x2x exactly as it was the case here. So I have to do it twice, to do the forward and the backward. Okay, so this is the contractor associated with this constraint. Now for this one, I don't have it yet because I have only programmed the contractor for the sine function. But now I know that so for y equal cos of x, I know that it is equivalent to y equal sine of p divided by 2 minus x. So I can decompose as follows. I will build a variable like this. I will call it z. And the same as I have done here, I can perform a forward-backward algorithm to build the contraction for the cos. So this will correspond, I will give it directly here. I will call it C cos. So C cos will contract x and y. The variable, the domain for the variable x and y. So I will have to build z, the intermediate variable. Z will correspond to the will be related by a minus or a plus. It depends on the direction of the rows between p divided by 2 and x. And then sine, which will give me y. So I will perform a forward-backward procedure. So I will have here the intermediate variable z are initialized to minus infinity plus infinity. Okay, I will denote by, let's say, p divided by 2 corresponds to p divided by 2, p divided by 2. All have to be intervals. Then I will perform the addition c add of p divided by 2 z and x. So it is an addition because due to this, I know that p divided by 2 is equal to x plus z. This is why I have add here. Then I will, once I'm here, I am performing the forward step like this. So I arrive here. And c sine of z and y. So up, I start the backward here, and again I have to do c add of p divided by 2 z and x. Okay, so the backward has been done and I have the contraction for the cos. Now I need to build a contractor for the two of them, and this I will call it c x and y. So how can I do this? I will compose the two of them. So I will call c sine square of x and y. This will contract both x and y. And then I will call c cos of x and y. So we can see that we build the complex contractor by a composition of elementary contractor. And we'll see later that IBEX makes it possible to do it in an automatic way. But here we do everything by hand to have a better understanding how we can build complex contractors to solve complex equations. The corresponding Python program is given here. I can see that this corresponds to this. This corresponds to this. And for the cos, this corresponds to this. And now I will call the CV algorithm with here I will not put this. I will put C, of course. So if I run the Civia with cos, I will see only the cos, you can see here. We check that it is minimal also. Here I can draw the sine square. Okay, it takes more time. Okay. Again, we can see that the contractor looks minimal because each box touch the constraint. But here, to solve the equation, I have to put here C, which intersect the two of them. If I run it, I get this. And I see all solutions for x and y. So it's difficult to see them. But here I have no solution. But here I have one, and I have plenty of them, like here and here, due to the specific function I have. Okay, so if I zoom, I can see some solution here. By transparency, I see that indeed I cross the solution. So it is not a proof, but it's just a check. And here also, I check that I also cross all solutions.